All right, all right. How's everybody? Woo! All right now. Everybody's been sitting patiently waiting for this moment, as much as I was also. Well, my name is Jimmy BigRook Hawkins. I want to ask you, what's the first thing that comes to mind when you hear the word barrier? A wall, right? Now, there are so many different types of barriers set to block you from your purpose, your mission, your goal, your passion. It's meant for that, right? How about thoughts? That can be a barrier, right? Thoughts, feelings, people's attitudes, and maybe even your own. Now, before I get any deeper, I would like to do something with all of you that I like to call the icebreaker. So, this is what we're gonna do. So let's practice on a little social engagement to test out my theory on how I believe that dance can get rid of some of the social stigmas that we face today. So if you all can raise real quick, please. Loosen up, I know you've been sitting down for a while. Now, I have a song that I love, and hopefully you guys love as well, and I'm not gonna tell you what to do. As soon as you hear the song, just let the music take over your body, okay? We're gonna rock with that. Just have a little character. There we go. There you go. How you feel? Oh, I see you. Okay. Okay. All right, come on, y'all. Take away. I see. I like that. There it is. I like that. Okay. All right, that was great. Give a round of applause for yourself. That was great. All right. Now, let me ask you, how does everybody feel? Happy, right? You look good. Now, let me ask you another question. Were you worried about how you looked? A little bit? Now, would you have been able to come on this little red dot right now and do the same thing in front of everybody else? Some would, and some wouldn't, and for all different reasons. Not everybody feels comfortable expressing themselves like that real quick, right? So dance can break down the inner and outer barriers that causes society's judgment upon us. Now, let me give you a little example. A couple weeks ago, I was at a bar restaurant because I'm of age. I could do that. And there was a lawyer sitting at the bar. He was down and out about something. I don't know what it was. And then there was a dentist next to him. They didn't know each other as well as much as I knew them as well. I didn't know them. But me doing what I do with dance, I was dancing. I was dancing near the speaker. And the lawyer turned around and started dancing along with me. Now, dance, my mom always taught me this. That's my beautiful mother. She taught me that you can also, you don't have to talk. Dance, you can talk through dance. You can talk through dance. So when he came to me, we were talking through dance. And to make this long story short, they didn't know each other, and they ended up, a week later, he came up to me and said, "Thank you, Rook. Last week was great." They ended up battling each other, ended up going on another date, on another date, on another date, and now they're getting married through dance. And they didn't even know each other as much as I didn't know them. So dance did that for them. Now, dance has always been a part of my life since I was about this tall, 2 years old. But at the age of 14 in 2004, a new dance form came to me called Crump. The acronym for Crump is Kingdom, Radically Uplifted, Mighty Praise. Now, Crump was a new form of religion that helped us channel our inner emotions through movement. It gave us purpose and the will to overcome social stigmas. Now, as a crumper in Buffalo, we would meet 2 times a week. Tuesdays, the big homies, the teachers, the instructors, would teach the kids fundamentals, arm throws, arm swings, etc. But on Fridays, we couldn't wait for Fridays. You know why? It was called a session. Now, a session is, imagine a group like this, all of us, all together, and there's one person in the middle. They get to express themselves freely. No judgment is placed upon them at all. They go through a lot during the week, but on that Friday, it's their one and only chance to actually be themselves and not be judged. Now, it didn't matter how they looked or dressed, etc. We just came together as a family and just danced. Now, sessions helped me with my mind, body, and soul, and I took that everywhere I went. It didn't matter where I was or who I was with. I always remember where I come from. Now, it's easy to feel judged when you are around those who are different from you and unfamiliar with you. If something like a session can bring people together and make them feel more comfortable about their true selves, why can't we channel experiences like that into everyday life? We face internal and mental barriers as well. The biggest one is the one internally that we always do. So, how many people in here has ever told themselves and to stop? How many told themselves? I'm sorry. How many people in here have ever told themselves that they couldn't do something? Now, how many people in here have ever told them, blocked themselves from speaking their mind because they were scared of negative reactions or negative rejection or just scared? We all have. Now, most people wouldn't just dance around people they didn't know like we did in the icebreaker, right? So feeling comfortable around others reduces insecurities. Now, dance can put you in a mindset that will overcome every barrier that is out there. But not everyone is a dancer, right? So find something that makes you feel the same way dance makes us feel and passionate about. And build a community around that, please, because we need that. This world right now is crazy, and dance can actually help because it's helped me. So with further ado, I would like to introduce my friend, my brother, that I met through this crump world, Kyle Rashid Muhammad. Now, Kyle and I, we always have conversations about overcoming obstacles together on this day-to-day basis, but if it wasn't for crump, pretty sure we probably wouldn't have known each other. But this crump stuff is crazy. So we're just going to put on a little show for you guys, and I will ask if you guys can open up your heart, your mind, bodies, and soul so that we can actually vent off our frustrations and what we're going through as well. Please, just enjoy, please. Thank you.
Straight off the plane, dropping a flame. Third.